Use the CAN bus signal type to decode the controller area network protocol. This full-featured decoder will decode the entire CAN 2.0b specification. We have already added a CAN bus signal to our project and captured some data. Let's open the signals editor to see its configuration options. Click on the signal name to open the editor. We will skip the general options and describe each option for this specific type of signal. Some decoders may have additional settings in channel options. This one lets you choose to invert the data before decoding it. Other custom settings are found under decode options. Show delimiters. When selected, delimiter fields will be visible in the output. Show CRC. When selected, CRC fields will be visible in the output. I will scroll the example area, so this next change can be seen. Show control bits. When selected, control bits fields will be visible in the output. Bit, rate, duration and scale. Specify a value for the bit, rate or the bit duration, then select a scale for the value entered. Scale selections include nanoseconds, microseconds, milliseconds, baud, kilobaud and megabaud. Note that the value must be an integer. To specify something with a decimal point, select the next lowest range and enter a whole number. For example, 115.2 kilobaud would be entered as 115,200 baud. Sample point, percent of bit. Specifies where we should sample the data, within each bit cell, as a percentage of the bit width. This defaults to mid-bit, 50%, and can be adjusted to account for bus, propagation delays, transceiver delays, bandwidth limitations, etc. Sync jump width, percent of bit. Specifies the percentage of a bit width to allow for resynchronization adjustments. This corresponds to the SJW parameter in the CAN specification. The CAN specification allows for a wide tolerance on node oscillators. This is accomplished by requiring that nodes resynchronize on passive dominate edges. This parameter specifies the maximum adjustment we will make when resynchronizing. Increasing this number increases our ability to properly decode packets involving nodes with low accuracy oscillators at the expense of increased noise sensitivity. You usually set this lower if all nodes use crystal oscillators for their baud rate reference. However, you would set this higher if any node uses a ceramic resonator or other low accuracy source as a baud rate reference. Filter glitches less than or equal to a percentage of the bit. DigiView has a much higher bandwidth than most CAN receivers, so it is capable of capturing glitches or noise pulses that normal receivers might not even see. A setting of 0 tells us to process full bandwidth data with poor rejection. Increasing this setting will make us simulate higher immunity parts. Selection ranges from 0% to 10%. This concludes our CAN bus demonstration.